Here we are, Gen Beauty. It's probably about 8:45 a.m. Registration should have already opened, and it hasn't. Ready for a long day. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do that so you don't miss out on any of my videos. From watching the intro, you obviously know what today's video is all about. And yeah, I went to Ipsy's Generation Beauty 2018 in Los Angeles, California at the LA Convention Center. I do want to go through my goodie bag and show you guys what I got for free. I also am going to show you a couple items that I purchased and then show you things that I got free while going from booth to booth. Before we actually get into the goodie bags, I just want to share with you a little bit of my experience. This year is the second time that I've been to Generation Beauty. I did go last year for 2017 when it was at LA Live in Los Angeles. The experience wasn't that great, but I just really love makeup, so I wanted to go again anyway. I only went one day last year. This year, I only went one day again. I was just kind of over it and I didn't want to go the second day. I felt like I was able to touch a lot of different booths and the ones that I missed just wasn't that big of a deal to me. So I just decided not to go to the second day. As far as purchasing tickets, when the tickets first launched and you can buy them on like an early bird special, I actually missed that early bird special. And then when I did purchase them, I had to pay full price, but I did get a 40% off discount through, I don't know, Ipsy had like a 40% off discount pretty much the entire time. I don't remember exactly how much the tickets were. I think they're like $160, and then I got 40% off of that. But I also added the lightning pass, and that was $40. This was the first year that they had an option of a lightning pass, and I think that's because of all the feedback that they received from last year's event. Just waiting in line was just horrendous. It's like you're waiting in line all day to go on a roller coaster and you never actually get on the roller coaster. So they had the option of buying an early, or sorry, they had the option of buying a lightning pass is what it was called, and it was just a separate line, and that line moved way faster than just the general admission. They also had an option to purchase an early pass, which got you into the event an hour early. I personally would have bought that, but the two friends that I was going with didn't want to buy that, so I didn't as well. I just got the lightning pass, and that was just gonna to be okay for me, even though I would have paid another $40 to get in there an hour early. And I personally think getting in there that hour early before everyone else is in there really gives you more of an advantage of how many booths going to be able to go to. Registration opens at 8:30 a.m., but people get there a little earlier to make sure they get in line and have a good spot in line. We left here around 7:05 maybe even 7:10. I'm not too sure. I don't remember. We got down there about like 7:30, 7:40. I think we were in line by like 7:45 at the latest. Registration's supposed to open at 8:30. Last year didn't open at that time. This year didn't open at that time either. It didn't open till almost 9, I believe, is when they let the early bird line go in first to actually register, and then you go wait in another line to actually get into the event. It was quite a little bit of time. I think it was almost 10 o'clock when they finally let us go into register. So we finally get into register, you get your wristband, we got our lightning pass band, and then we have to wait in another line to actually get into the event. I think that last year was super, super unorganized as far as the lines, where to go, what to do. I felt like this year was a little bit more organized, but then it was still unorganized to where I was almost getting like super frustrated. Like things start happening and I just feel like the event staff is just like stressing out, and they almost start being a little bit rude to you, and it's kind of like, it just ruins the whole vibe that you're there for. I think it was a little after 11 when the line started moving and we were actually walking into the event. As far as the event space, it was way bigger than it was last year. There was a lot more room to like walk around. I think it made it feel like there were more brands there, even though I don't think there were more brands there. The actual space that we were in was way nicer and better than last year. They have like a little lounge area, and then they had a couple people performing throughout the day. They had like a cafeteria, they had seating, eating areas, and then they had a couple food trucks outside. What I did appreciate more this year than last year was that there were multiple bathrooms around the entire place, whereas last year there weren't that many bathrooms. Actually, there was only one area for bathrooms, and they weren't like the nicest bathrooms, and they were outside. They're like those expensive type porta potty bathroom trucks. I don't know what you would call them, but yeah. As far as like using the lightning pass, I don't think I could ever go back to Gen Beauty without using this lightning pass, because it definitely kept you moving through the lines way faster than the general admission people. And I honestly felt bad for the general admission people, just kind of watching them like stand in line, not really moving. And then once we got into the lightning line, like it went pretty quickly. And I think that's why I was able to see so many more booths this year than I did last year. We got into the NYX booth line, and we literally stood there for 30 minutes, and we were in the lightning pass line, and we did not move like one bit. And so we got kind of frustrated, and I'm like, let's get out of this line. We can come back or come back tomorrow, whatever, and jump back in it. But it just wasn't moving. I don't know what they were doing inside their little booth area that was causing the line to not be able to move. But that one was specifically super frustrating for us. So we didn't even stay in the line. I didn't even get any product from NYX. Based on how the event goes, right now I'm thinking to myself that I won't go next year, just because what's the point? I was super, super tired, like walking all day. I got up at 5 a.m. to get super glam. Probably when it gets closer to next year, I will still probably end up going, just because I love makeup. I like being able to look at my goodie bags and look at all the stuff that I have afterwards. I'm trying to think if I missed anything as far as the actual event itself. So if I remember anything along the way, I will just throw that out there. If you have any questions about the event, please comment down below. I will get back to you and answer any of the questions that you guys have. But let's get into these goodie bags and let me show you what I got. Here are the bags that I got, you guys. It's out of control. My arm's getting tired. There's still two bags down here that I couldn't even grab to show you. We got a lot of stuff here. I don't even know where to start, how to do this, how long this damn video is gonna be, so just bear here with me. I'm gonna show you guys the items that I actually purchased while I was there, just because it's only a few. First, we went to the Too Faced booth and I purchased the new Natural collection. We got the Natural Face palette and we have the Natural Matte palette. I'm actually wearing these products on my face today, and I did film a video using both these palettes, so make sure you guys keep your eye out for that, because that will be coming very shortly after this video. The reason why I purchased those, for one, is because they're beautiful in person, and two, because the line was cut off because I think there was going to be a meet and greet, but then they were like, if you are going to purchase something, you can just come straight to the counter, make your purchase, and get your free product. So I was like, oh, all you have to do is purchase something and you're gonna get your free product and you don't have to wait in that line? Of course I'm gonna buy something. So I was like, girls, let's go. And they only had certain things. They had the entire Natural collection, and they had their peach palette, which is like their bestseller or whatever. That was really it. They might have had some primers and their eyeshadow insurance and things like that, but I'm like, really? I wish they would have had the Just Peachy mattes, because I totally would have bought that. And they were 40% off, so I didn't have to wait in line. They're 40% off and they're actually really beautiful in person. So that was a great deal. The next products that I actually purchased were from The Balm Cosmetics. The reason why I bought these is because they are 50% off and I actually really like The Balm. I just don't have many of their products. So I'm super excited to try out the palettes. If you guys want to see a video on these, just comment down below. Those were the only items that I actually purchased. You guys, I brought a good amount of money with me, because I was ready to spend some money. But those are the products that I purchased. Now I think we should jump into the goodie bag and show you guys all the products that we got for free. You get the goodie bag with your purchase of the ticket, and there's supposed to be over $400 worth of product in that bag. So let's see what we got. So first, here is the bag. It's just like a little backpack. You have It Naturals. Never heard of this company, so I'm really excited to try this. I'm all about leave-in conditioners and conditioners. It's a 12-in-1 amazing leave-in treatment. From Shea Moisture, we have silicone-free Miracle Styler leave-in treatment. Vital Proteins collagen peptide. It's powder and you can add it to coffee or tea, smoothies, juice, oatmeal or yogurt, soups or broths. What? And it's a dietary supplement for hair, skin, nails, bones, and joints. Wow, I wonder if I'm actually going to try that out. Okay, we have a pro makeup contour brush from Moda. From the cream shop, we have matcha green tea face mask. From Too Faced, we have the Hangover RX primer. And I will just say, what really sucks about what Too Faced did was they put this in the goodie bag, and that's your product from them in the goodie bag, and then the free product that they were handing out was the same primer. Like, really, guys, you couldn't give us a different product, like a mini Better Than Sex mascara? I felt like that was a little cheap of Too Faced to do that, but that's just my opinion. Next, from Pacifica, we have a Crystal Melon makeup removing wipe. So, I only use one type of makeup remover wipes, and those are from Costco, so I will definitely try those out. From the Nature Lab, we have a shampoo and conditioner. From, I don't even know how to say that, Soe, a donkey milk skin gel mask. Donkey milk? Okay. From Lancome, a hydrogel melting mask. I do like masks, so I'm excited to try this out. And I will say, Lancome, that was probably my favorite booth that we went into, just like all the different things that you did. They had little candy things, I don't know what to call them, and then there was a wheel that you spun. It was just like a really cool experience going through that booth, so shout out to Lancome, favorite booth of the event. So we get a 25% off on lilylashes.com. I'm hoping this is not what we received from Lily Lashes, and I actually didn't even make it to that booth, so I don't even know what they were handing out, but if this is all that's in the goodie bag, that's pretty lame, Lily. From Freeman Beauty Infusion, Revitalizing Peel Off Mask, so another mask. From Eyelure, we have lengthening lashes that look really, really thin and natural, and I am excited to try those out. From Physicians Formula, we have a cute little smoky nude eyeshadow palette. I'm living for this little shimmer color right there. From Marc Anthony, we have the hydrating coconut oil and shea butter. Okay, so it's like a leave-in oil treatment, And I will just say about this product, so the people that were behind us in line, you walk in and you get your goodie bag and then you are still waiting in line to get in the actual event. So then you have everybody in line basically sitting down going through their bag. I looked at a couple things, but people were pulling every single item out and it's just like, really, like, calm it down, like, look at your stuff later. I don't know, that's just me. The chick behind us, all of a sudden her entire bag was just like all oily. Come to find out, the lid popped off of this and this spilt in her entire bag. If I was her, I would have walked back up to that counter and been like, give me a new bag. Like, this is ridiculous. Next, we have a Dirty Little Secret lip gloss. Let's just see what color it is. Ooh, that's a dark lip gloss. All right. From Buxom, we have a Plumping Full Voluminous Lashes Mascara. From Note, we have a Hydra Color Lip Gloss. Ooh, that's kind of cute. From Bella Pierre, we have a lipstick, and I believe it's this color. It's called Sassy. From Laritzi Cosmetics, we have a lip pencil. Oh, it's definitely like a pink color. I like me some lip liners. From Pop Beauty, we have this, I think it's just an eyeliner. Another item from Marc Anthony. Okay, Marc Anthony, throwing two items in there. We have a Grow Long Super Fast Miracle Treatment. Ooh, from Luxie, we have a brush, Duo Fiber Stippling Brush. Ooh, I'm excited to, a lot of stuff flying off of it. I'm excited to try this for my foundation. We have a Pale Purple Nail Polish from Koki. From Ava NYE or NYC, we have a 10-in-1 primer for hair. From MAC, we have a Frost Lipstick, pinky color. CoverGirl? I don't even know, was there a CoverGirl booth? This is a lip gloss, the Katy Perry lip gloss. From Belief, we have a Hungarian Water Essence. It's like a moisturizer, I think. Then we have from Brio Geo, we have the Blow Dry Perfection and Heat Protectant Cream. Then we have from Derma E, Nourishing Rose Cleansing Oil. From Pure Lease, we have a Mud Mask and Exfoliant. From IBY Beauty, we have a Velour Liquid Lip. So this is a liquid lip. Ooh, yeah, liquid lip. I like this color. From Grande, we have a primer. Oh, it's a lash plumping primer. Okay. From Essence, we have an eyeliner pen. Seems a little flimsy, but we're gonna be testing that out. From Pixi, we have an Endless Silky Eye Pen. God, I have so many of those. Not from Pixi, but from Bioderma, Shine Control Moisturizer. From Pure, we have Correcting Primer. And this is from Meg. It's a twin nail duo nail polish. Lovey-dovey. Okay. And then from The Balm, we have, what is this? A blush palette. Oh, I really like The Balm. Oh, and it has a mirror too. How cute. I'm excited for these blushes. One last product from Fat Boy, it's hair putty. So that's everything that came in the goodie bag. What are you guys thinking? Let me throw all this stuff back into the bag and then I'm gonna go through and show you the products that I got from walking through the booth. Here is the Marc Anthony bag. I'm really liking this bag. Inside, we have the Strengthening Grow Long Anti-Breakage Oil. Here is the IBY Beauty. Oh, this is a highlighter. It's all taped up. I'm not gonna even try to open it with my nails right now. We got a little angled brush right here. We have another liquid lip. Let's make sure it's not the same color that was in my bag. That would suck. And I think it is the exact same color that was in the goodie bag. Who am I gonna have to give this to now? We have the Ava NYC bag. There's other products that I threw in here as we were going. Got a $2 off of Ulta card. $2, really? Purse Perfect Hair Towelette. Tames Frizz, Smooths Flyaways. Oh, this is from that Soe. Soe. We got a Black Charcoal Hydrogel Mask. Sleeping Mask, okay. Need some more masks. I'm not mad at it. Here is the Balm bag, and I have a bunch of different products from different booths in here. So let's start dipping in here. First, we have a little Belief bag. What did we get in here? Moisturizing Eye Balm. The Hungarian Water Essence. We got a toner. From Texture, we have a Defining Gel, Defining Cream. And then we have Hydrating Conditioner and a Scalp Saver. So that's cool. Essence, we have a Shape and Shadows Palette. And it comes with a little spoolie angled flat brush. From Brio Geo, we got a Deep Conditioning Mask. I love these. We have a Daily Moisturizer from Pure Lease. From Lancome, we have the mascara. From IGK, we have a texture spray. I really like texture sprays. From Physicians Formula, it's an illuminating primer. I'm definitely trying this. I'm thinking I'm gonna try everything that I got, so I'll stop saying that now. From Moda, I got a fan brush. Oh, and here's a little Polaroid we took. And that was at the Lancome booth. That's right, they took a little picture of us on their Polaroid, and then you could put it on a wall or keep it. I kept it. Oh, from Lancome, this is a... Oh, what is this? I think it's a lip product, but that's kind of weird. From The Balm, we got a little eyeshadow. Oh, and I got this from The Balm free, their scuba mascara, because I spent more than $25 at the booth. 15% off Dirty Little Secrets. From C'est Moi, it's a makeup crayon, so an eyeliner in white, so I'm loving that because I love white eyeliner on my waterline right now. From Trustique, it's a lip crown duo thing. I spun the wheel and I got the full size, not the mini size. And from Dirty Little Secret, another lipstick. That's it for the balm bag. Now I got my Too Faced bag, and I have a bunch of products from other places too. This is the actual foundation card from Jouer, because I got a deluxe sample of their foundation that they just launched, 33 more shade colors, and I am very, very excited to try this. Jouer was the first booth that we went to when we got inside the event, because I wanted to make sure we got the foundation and it didn't run out, and I got the shade Honey Beige, so I hope that works out. Can't wait to test that out. From Shea Moisture, we got a body wash and a body lotion. From Maybelline, I got a little City Mini palette, the Downtown Sunrise, and you got to pick from any of their, I think it was like 5 palettes, and honestly, I wanted every single one of them looking at them, but this is the one that I picked. Derma E, oh, and this is so funny. So we were just like walking by, and they're throwing things out, so we stopped and put up our hands, and I actually caught it. I couldn't believe it. It's a microdermabrasion scrub. Did I say that right? Bioderma, we got Shine Control Moisturizer. From Koki, a lip gloss, super dark lip gloss. BP, I can't even think of what brand this is, but it's a makeup base. Here's the primer that you got from waiting in line at the Too Faced booth. Just a little bit bigger than the other sample that they threw in the goodie bag. I just think that was so cheap. From Pure, this is a liquid highlighter or a liquid eyeshadow. It's a liquid glitter type thing, and I'm very, very excited for that. Luxe, we have an angled blender. From Pixie, we got a lip gloss. Oh, we got a 25% off card to Too Faced as well. And then from Grande Lips, a hydrating lip plumper. And I forgot about these, and I just ate one of the candies, but this was a little cup that you got inside the Lancome booth. We got some gumballs and then some other candy. Really good. That's it for the Too Faced bag. And those are all the products that I got at Gen Beauty 2018. I think I made out pretty damn well, to be honest, after I'm pulling them all out and actually looking at everything, because yesterday when I got home, I didn't look at anything. I was so tired, I literally went straight to sleep. But now being able to pull everything out and look at everything that I got, I really made out with some really, really good products. Some new brands that I haven't tried before, so I'm excited to try them out. I am very satisfied with everything that I got from Gen Beauty. How exciting! If you guys have any questions about any of the products that I showed you from the goodie bag or just any of the products in general, please leave me a comment down below. I would love to answer your questions, so don't be afraid to comment. Now that I just went through the bag, I think I'll be going next year. I know I am. I know I'm gonna go. I think I have covered all bases. This totally brings us to the end of the video. Oh, I'm feeling kind of sad. Like, that's it? I wanna, like, look at some more products. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this Gen Beauty 2018 small vlog footage major goodie bag unboxing video, please leave me a thumbs up, drop a comment down below, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys!